Yep, he saw me. There you go, guys. That's a fish. There you go, guys. That's unreal! Oh, this is such an awesome-looking fish. Oh, yeah! All right, guys, check that out.
What's up, everyone? Scott the Chart Hammer here, and I'm getting rigged up for some pan fishing and bass fishing I'm going to do tomorrow before work. You know, this weather, I've got one thing on the mind, and that's pond fishing. Getting back to one of my fortes, one of my favorite types of fishing. This time of year is absolutely magical. The transition that happens from the weather and the fish getting more active, oh, I'm so ready. But I figure now's a good time to tell another fishing story. Now, this one I left up to a vote to you, my subscribers. I did a community poll like 5 or 6 days ago asking you guys what you wanted to hear my next fishing story to be about, and you guys voted, and the result was me catching my personal best bass, which was 7.5 pounds, and was caught on this lure right here. If you guys want to get in on these polls, because I'm going to do a lot more videos that are based on polls based on what you guys want to see, or if you guys haven't already, hit that subscribe button down there, notify bell next to it, so you're going to be the first to see all the great content that's going to come from this channel, and if your account setting is on public and I can read your name, I'll give you a shout out in the video I record over the weekends. So if you're new to the channel, or if you guys don't know this from these fishing stories are based on stories that have taken place before I had a camera or when I wasn't recording, like when I was out fishing and didn't have the camera with me. So it was 2016. I've said so many times already on this channel, 2016 was the best fishing year I've ever known. And so far, this winter and going into the spring looks exactly like 2016 all over again. So I'm stoked for this year. But anyway, it was a couple months after catching my, what was at the time, personal best bass of 5 pounds. It was the first big bass I ever caught. I think my personal best before that was literally like maybe a pound, pound and a half. So not much bigger than that. I just got into big bass fishing. So I had some more big bass lures, in particular the BBZ Rat. And I was taking this lure all over the place. I already had an understanding of a topwater fishing. You want really shallow, warm water. So I was looking for those shallow flats in every pond I went to, things that were places that were like 5 feet deep or shallower. And it was in August, so it was in probably the hottest part of that summer in 2016. And I kept starting to fish like an hour, maybe an hour and a half before dusk, because that's the time when topwater really turns on in the area, especially the shallow ponds around here. But anyway, so I take this lure to Waverly and I go to a spot where I've seen a big bass swirling a lot and fishing that area previously the last couple of weeks before doing this. And this time I came with the BBZ Rat. I was fishing it on a big rod. I actually don't know if I still have the rod. Actually, yes, I still do. Now this rod got absolutely destroyed by fishing in the ocean. So sort of got retired over here to my pantheon of glorious retired rods. It's because it was a big heavy lure. I had to use a big heavy rod with that. And I wasn't really used to casting with a big heavy rod like that for bass fishing. And my wife was with me that night and I had the net with me just in case I got something too big I couldn't get out of the water. And I cast over to this area at the lake where there's this rock bar that comes out to a point, this gravel bar that comes out to a point. And I cast like right on the outer edge of that point where I saw something swirling. Cast out, reeled it about maybe 3 feet, and then something swirled right behind it. Something blew up, like probably trying to strike the tail, but missed. And I just went like, just puckered up and just like slowly crept the lure, but nothing happened. Reeled in quick and cast out again about 3 feet past where I cast, and then started reeling, and then bam, something huge hit it. Now, on that rod a week prior, I landed a 16-pound salmon. So I know what a 16-pound fish felt like, and this thing had that rod loaded as much as that 16-pound fish. And it hit on the surface just like a bass. It started fighting like a bass, but like I said, that rod was loaded like it was a big fish. I'm yelling for my wife, get the net, get the net! And she sees how loaded my rod is. She's like, what do you have? I'm like, this is a bass. This is a big bass. I fought it for about 40 seconds, and then it came off the lure, probably through one of the hooks, but when I pulled the lure out of the water, I still had a chunk of flesh on one of the treble hooks, so I know I had the fish in the mouth. So that got me absolutely laser-focused on that spot, wanting to catch that big bass again, and I went back the next night, throwing the same lure, exact same time of day, exact same spot, and within 3 casts, landed this fish. Now, Steve, you guys have seen me fish with him. Steve that works over at Sportsman's, he was the one who helped me land the bass, so, you know, credit to him also, and also credit to him for taking that photo. And I really wish I could say I was completely satisfied with that catch. I mean, it was my personal best for this area, for Oregon in general. Catching a 7.5-pounder is rare. And again, it was caught on the BBZ Rat. Now, this is a 2.5-ounce 10-inch swim bait. From nose to tail, this thing is 10 inches. It's a wake bait. And, I mean, those big, I think those are, I think those are 2-aught treble hooks. Big lure, big hooks, you know, big fish is going to go for something like this. But also give you some size comparison, you know, the size of lure, and then that picture again, you see how big that fish actually was. People look at that fish and they look at the length and they go, that's not a very big fish. But then I remind them, this is the lure that I caught it on. That thing's mouth was huge and that thing was a football. You also got to remember, when I hold a fish, it's going to look smaller than when the average fisherman catches a fish. I'm 6'3" and 300 pounds. Do the math. A 7.5-pounder in my hands is going to look like a 4-pounder in, say, LFG's hands. But like I said, I wish I could say I was fully satisfied with that catch, but I wasn't, because I know what I lost the night before. Still my personal best bass, I'm still trying to beat it, but that does mean there is probably a state record fish hiding in that lake. I mean, if I were to be as conservative as I could be based on how the rod felt from the fish I landed the day prior, knowing how hard bass fight... conservative, I'd say that was 13, which would be a state record. I think the state record is 10.2 or 10.4. But yeah, it is getting close to the time to start hooking around these lures again, and I'm hoping to catch that fish. Also hoping to beat my personal best. But let me know what you guys thought down in the comments down below, and if you guys want to see my other fishing stories, I'll put the playlist and a link up here in this corner. If you guys enjoyed this video, do me a favor, hit that like button, and if you haven't already, like I said, hit that subscribe button down there, notify bell next to it, so you're going to be the first to see all the great content that's going to come from this channel. There's also going to be giveaways coming up, because I hit 1,000 subscribers and I still want to celebrate that. I'm just waiting for something to do for a giveaway. I want it to be seasonally relevant, too. And again, when you subscribe, if your account setting is on public and I can read your name, I'll give you a shout out in my weekend video. But other than that, thank you guys so much for watching, or in this case, thank you so much for listening to another fishing story. And as always, tips up, tight lines, and have fun fishing.